time. My name is Taka. I started competing in 2007. I used a blend of Arabica and Robusta. My roaster couldn't share any details of my coffees. It was normal back then. Over the years, Arabica took over, showcasing amazing flavors. Now, in the recent years, Robusta has begun to catch up, thanks to modern fermentation techniques. So, like I did in 2007, I'm going to serve you the blend of Arabica and Robusta. But this time, it's my choice to give you the best espresso possible. Taking the best of Robusta, the body, and the best of Arabica, the flavors. So, let's start with espresso. Please have a look at my card on your left. My Arabica is Geisha variety from Finca Hartmann, Panama. Natural anaerobic fermentation. The producer, Latibo Hartmann, has green and bronze tip geishas, giving clean floral and tropical fruit notes to the coffee. Today, as orange blossom and pineapple. He applied 130 hours anaerobic fermentation and then dried in cherry juice, giving grape notes to the coffee. Today is red grape and white wine aftertaste. My Robusta is TR4 variety from Eatang Cooperative in Vietnam, also a natural anaerobic fermentation. This variety at this farm grows at 1,000 meters above sea level, which is higher than any other farms in Vietnam. That's why the cherries ripen slower, developing great sugar contents, giving more sweetness, more body to the cup. Then the coffee was processed as anaerobic fermentation for 5 days, and then dried in cherries, removing the vegetal and tobacco flavors of Robusta. I'm dosing 19 grams of geisha, 1 gram of Robusta, extracting 40 grams out in 21 seconds. By having 1 gram of Robusta, it increases the body and enhances the texture. Once I serve you espresso, please evaluate the crema and wait for my instruction. Don't drink yet. Please, evaluate the crema. Wait for my instruction. Please, evaluate the crema. Wait for my instruction. Please. Okay, your taste experience. Please write down. Medium sparkling stoic acidity. Medium sweetness. Low bitterness. First sip, pineapple, orange. Second sip, red grape, orange blossom. Medium body. Smooth mouthfeel and long-lasting aftertaste, white wine, like Riesling. Please stir 3 times and go ahead. Please put the used spoon in the black glass. Enjoy! Okay, so let's move on to a milk drink. I'm dosing 17 grams of geisha, 3 grams of lobster, extracting 40 grams out in 18 seconds. By having more lobster, it highlights the sweet flavors in the cup. Your taste experience, please write down. Dark chocolate, dark cherry, hint of vanilla. And please enjoy buttery mouthfeel. My lobster TR4 was recognized as a variety back in 2006, almost like me, as starting to compete as a barista. TR4 normally has big body, herbal notes, and decent bitterness. Thanks to the anaerobic fermentation, this bitterness is rounded. And now, matches very well with the my Arabica. My approach to blend is to roast Arabica and Robusta separately. For Arabica, I chose to emphasize the flavor by roasting short. For Robusta, I chose to emphasize the body by having longer roast. Thank you for waiting. Please enjoy. Please enjoy. Just a moment, please. I manage different solubility of each roast by having separate grinders. Fine setting for Arabica, coarser setting for Robusta. Thank you for waiting. Please enjoy. Please enjoy. Okay, for my signature drink, I was inspired by Espresso Martini, a classic, amazing drink. I'm dosing 15 grams of geisha, 5 grams of robusta, extracting 36 grams out in 16 seconds. By having even more robusta, it boosts the flavors. Please have a look at cup. My first ingredient is herb distillation. This is rose petal, matching the floral note of my coffee. Cardamom seed, giving spicy kick to my coffee. And hops, highlighting the citric note of my coffee. I distillate them all together for one day. I add 40 grams of this distillation, so your first sip will be citric and botanical. Today has grapefruit and juniper berry. My second ingredient is Japanese sugar. It's called kokutou, made by sugarcane juice that is cooked for a very long time. The intensity of this sugar matches well with the sweetness of my espresso. I made a syrup with kokutou sugar and water at a 1-to-1 ratio. I add 15 grams of kokutou syrup, so the sweetness of my espresso turns into tonka beans today. My last ingredient is coffee pack. I collected the coffee pack from my practices. Added water and koji, which is Japanese fungus. Then fermented in this sealed container for 2 weeks, just in the anaerobic condition, just like my coffee. It becomes a paste and offers rich umami. The red fruit note of my coffee today as red grape turns into blood orange. I add 0.5 grams of this into the drink. And here, my 4 shots of espressos. And I add stainless ice cubes and shake together to give some texture. Your espresso martini is served cold. And please enjoy in two sips. Your taste experience, please write down. First sip, grapefruits, juniper berry. Second sip, blood orange, tonka beans. Your mouthfeel is round. Then becomes a smooth. With long aftertaste, dark chocolate. Remind me of espresso martini. It's a great pleasure for me to have served a blend of Arabica and Robusta and espresso martini. Like I did it my very first competition 15 years ago. And I'm also looking forward to the next 15 years to come as a barista. Please enjoy. ありがとうございました。Time.
All the applause for the barista champion of Japan.